Hey guys, Jaylee Play Sims here with another speed build for you. So this is a continuing video of the series that I kind of started in the Sims 3 renovation series, where I've only done one video before this, but I just went around Sunset Valley, I think it is, and just edited some of the pre-existing houses that we kind of got in the base game and just made them, you know, added some custom content or made them a little bit more modern or that sort of thing with a family in mind. So the first video in that series was when I renovated the monotone, and that one's up. You can go check that out if you want to look. And this one I kind of pictured, I didn't have a budget for the last one I did, but I kind of thought, I think I just get restrained by budget, and I thought it would be more fun if I didn't have one. So I'm trying to build a bridge here because I thought that would be cool, but I just completely scrap it because it was just not working. I was trying to follow the Sim Supplies video on how to build a bridge, and I think it's a really good tutorial, but it just was really difficult because it wasn't a normal kind of flat area. So yeah, it just wasn't working, so I scrapped it. But I kind of pictured this to be more of a holiday house, I guess, you know, because it's got the lake maybe, but so not a permanent home, and it has got a kind of, I guess, more of like a beachy, relaxed feel to it. And I made it a lot more modern and a bit less shabby, I guess you could say. It ends up with 3 bedrooms. So it's got a master and then 2 small kids' bedrooms. But in those 2 bedrooms, it's got bunk beds. So it's kind of like maybe the kids could share a room or something like that. Because I know at my holiday house, my sister and I have like a shared room, and I tried not to make it too specific to a family. I kind of just wanted to keep them kind of general, because I think at a holiday house, you know, you're not the only ones going there. You can rent it out, I think some people do, or like sometimes we've just got friends that want to go to the area that our holiday house is in, so we're just like, oh, you can use ours if you want. So like they stay in the rooms, and yeah, just kind of, it's not really your room, but it kind of is. So you kind of decorate it, but you also kind of leave it so that other people would be comfortable to stay there, I guess. So I started recording, and I don't know what happened, but I think I deleted it or something like that happened. So basically I had to start all over again. Yeah, I think my game crashed. And then so I just kind of recorded. But of course, when I started again, I didn't record. So I just kind of, I think it's pretty much the same. I just kind of went up to where it was before in the clip before. But yeah, I do that a lot. I always just forget to record. I have a lot of builds on my gallery that I don't upload, because I film the first half or I film the second half and I don't film in between or something like that, or I just accidentally delete files all the time. So I even actually build, I think in one of my first videos I said I was gonna build my house or my old house in The Sims, and I did it, but I had like 2 out of 3 clips. But I must have accidentally deleted the 3rd clip, and I was like, I can't upload like 2/3 of a video. So it's up on the gallery if you want to look at it. You can just use the hashtag JLEEplaySims, but I was like, I can't be bothered remaking it or refilming it. Or I know some people do those reverse speed builds where they kind of just delete everything one by one, and then yeah, I just could not be bothered doing that. I'm not very good with computers or editing. I'm so bad at editing. I think The Sims 3 renovation series is probably going to end with this video, just because these were the two houses that I really wanted to renovate, I guess, and there wasn't really any others that I wanted to renovate, or I even have any ideas of how to renovate it. So yeah, it'll probably end with this one, but building this got me so much more excited for The Sims 3, and it got me back into building, because I was kind of at that stage in The Sims 4 building where I'm like, I don't even know what to build anymore, because all the houses just look the same and it's so hard to furnish. But I don't get that in The Sims 3. In The Sims 3, I get like, oh, there's too many pieces that I want to use in a house, I guess. So yeah, I'll definitely, because I have ideas for houses, particularly ones with garages, that I just never wanted to go back to The Sims 3 because CreateSim is so slow. But I think I will maybe just do the houses in The Sims 3 that I want to build in The Sims 4, just because it's too hard. So yeah, if I ever have like a harder build or build with a garage, I'll do it in The Sims 3. And the way that I've kind of had my videos going for, I guess, just the past 2 weeks and this week, is a Sims 4 build on a Monday, or this is my time, so Australian time, Melbourne, I'm not sure the acronym, but so a Sims 4 speed build on a Monday, and then a Sims 3 speed build on a Friday. So there's two videos a week. Not sure what that noise was. So yeah, and I think that's working now for me. It's not too much. It's just, I start uni next week, and I'm a full-time uni student, and I also work part-time. So it's going to be pretty difficult to be uploading two videos a week. And it's also kind of difficult to pre-record, just because, I don't know, there's so many updates, and I think I'm just still getting used to filming and editing and all that. I've just got to try and make time for it. But, and I'm also going away in August, and I'd like to have like one video a week up for then, so it's even more pre-recording, I guess. And I'll see how I go. I think maybe the two videos a week, probably not gonna happen. I haven't even started back at uni yet, and I'm already struggling, so probably not gonna happen. But I think I could probably do one video a week. I think that would be cool, because then some weeks I could film like two or three videos and then just edit them over time, and then like some weeks, of course, I won't have any time to do it. Particularly when it comes to exams and mid-semester and all that. I actually love this kitchen. Like, I don't know, I just miss all the different options for plants, and I think I should try again with the CC content in The Sims 4, just because it makes it so much more fun to use. But I don't know, I think I'm scarred from the last time when it completely screwed up my game, and I think that's actually why, oh no, that was a different build. Yeah, that's why my sim home in The Sims 4 kind of stuffed up, because I had CC content and I had to, The Sims 4 wouldn't start, so I had to uninstall and reinstall my game, which I didn't even actually have to do in the end, because once I uninstalled it, I tried to start it again, it still wouldn't work. And then so I deleted all my CC, and then it worked. So yeah, I kind of unnecessarily lost a whole bunch of my builds, but I think I got most of them back because they were on the gallery. But I don't know, for some reason they were saved in a saved game, but it just didn't work. I added an extra level just because I thought that would be cool, and also because I didn't really have enough room for the three bedrooms that I wanted. So the top room ends up being the parents' room, I guess, or I guess the master bedroom. And then I guess you couldn't really have two couples stay here, but I think it is more of like, I had a particular family in mind, maybe like a teen, a family with a teenager and a small child, just because they could take their friends, I guess, because there's two. Yeah, I think I always took my friends when I went on holidays because it just got so boring. And there's a little closet. I don't even think I put anything in there. And then, yeah, making use of Creator Style, because I've missed it so much. It's just so much easier to style a room when you've got Creator Style. Why do I keep calling it? I'll just call it Kaz. I know the Sim Supply, he brought up a good point where it was, I can't even remember it now. It was something to do with, we don't need Creator Style, because I get that it does slow down your game so much, and I think it was probably a good idea for The Sims 4 creators to be like, no, that's not going to be in The Sims 4. I think that was a good decision, but I just think that the swatches is lacking and the matching of colors is lacking in The Sims 4. Like, you've got a red couch matching with another red, sitting chair, and they just look nothing alike. I just think I think they need an overall color wheel that can just go, like, you don't have to change the fabric or anything like that of a chair, but I just think that there should be a color wheel. Like, I don't think that would slow down the game that much, like, personally. Or even, that's right, The Sim Supply, I don't think it was his idea, I think he said he'd read it somewhere, but he brought up the point that for beds in particular, like, just having a mattress where you could change the sheets, but you could also, and I'm not explaining it well, so you can get the frame and then you can choose the frame and then you buy the mattress and put the mattress on top. I think that was such a good idea, because then you've got so much more options about, so many more options between the frame and matching it to the bed sheets. I just think, or even if you went back to how it was in The Sims 2, it's just, yeah, I think when you've got a bed and you can only have a particular pattern in different colors on that bed, it kind of ruins it, because that bed would match, but maybe you don't want those sheets. I don't know. I just think it limits creativity a lot. A lot, a lot. I'm doing the kids' rooms now, and I really liked how the kids' rooms turned out. I did the typical white furniture. So typical of me. I love bunk beds though. I think they look sick. That's probably my favorite thing that they introduced into Sims 3. In saying that, overall, I do think Sims 4 is a way better game. Obviously, the graphics and everything. Sorry, the graphics and just everything about The Sims 4 is so much better as a base game, I think. I think if you compare The Sims 3 base game to The Sims 4 base game, Sims 4 is a million times better. It's just that we're comparing The Sims 3 in its finished form to The Sims 4 as a base game. I thought it was cool that the beanbags, I want beanbags in The Sims 4. I would use them so much. I even have a beanbag in my room, actually. They do not look as cool as those. They look more like chairs in the game. But yeah, and then that's the teenage room with the beanbags. And I thought that, you know, maybe they've got a TV and they can, because when you're a teenager, that's all you do when you're on holidays at a holiday house. You just play games. That's it. With your friends. And then the kids have more play stuff, I guess. In terms of toys and all that. But yeah, I did my typical white walls, typical brown floorboards. I just think it looks nice in a house. Like, I would never buy a house that wasn't white walls, floorboards, brown floorboards. So yeah, that's just my style, what I like. I hate carpet, especially in The Sims. Carpet is disgusting. It just looks like an awkward floor. And I'm so bad at bathrooms. I've discovered that that is my weakness. Kitchens and bathrooms. Because I just do not spend time on the walls and my layout is always awkward. I guess I'll try and work on that. But that's what I love about the gallery is that even though I try not to use it in my building videos because that's kind of gets a bit complicated with the crediting and whatnot. But yeah, I usually do that when I'm off camera and playing by myself, pretty much. Not my kitchen and my bathrooms are always taken from the gallery. Like, I just like it so much better. But yeah, I think we're coming up to the screenshots in a minute. Did I not film the room or something? I'm not sure. Yeah. I think you'll see it in the screenshots though. I love that room. I think that looks so cool. And then the kitchen, I do like that. That's like that fridge just looks so much nicer than any of the fridges we have in The Sims 4. And the cute little desk area. I just think it's got like a really beachy vibe, even though it's at a lake, I think. Yeah, I guess that's kind of silly. But yeah, you can check out this on the gallery by searching hashtag JaylyPlaySims, or even just searching my origin ID, which will be down below. But I hope you guys enjoyed this build. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe for more videos. And I hope you guys have a great day. Bye.